The deaths must be proud of this scene. And they must be proud of their general. Yes, Manila, the town, Corregidor, all in Jap hands now. The news is different this year.
Ruth, I wish those men of ours that are held prisoners by the Japs could know that the help that they've waited for so long is well on the way and that they're not forgotten.
You're damned right they know, Lieutenant. Help is on the way. Kind of help we wish we could have sent them when their back was against the wall on Bataan and Corregidor. But it took time and sweat to build those ships, which are pushing their way across the Pacific today in ever-increasing numbers. And it took months of training to build a fighting army, too. But now we're rolling. Now GIs from Atlanta and El Paso, Green Bay and Three Rivers, are jamming the docks of Melbourne and Sydney. Guys and fighting equipment from the USA down under to do a little job. Guadalcanal, Buna, at two. That was only a beginning, Lieutenant. Only a beginning.
Although ladies rarely celebrate birthdays, these young ladies are justly proud on May 14, 1943, the first anniversary of the founding of the Women's Army Auxiliary Corps. It hasn't been an easy year for the woman soldier. Despite efficient accomplishment of her duties, sideline quarterbacks have taken pot shots at her from every angle. Old-timers eyed her with all the caution of a sourdough approaching a rattlesnake. Rumors flew thick and at random. And many a yardbird had it straight from the feed box that the WACs were the Army's biggest problem since Private SNAFU joined up. Yet 1 year after the birth of the Corps, the WAC has a 201 file that stacks up well with the best of them. He's serving with General Eisenhower overseas, so efficiently that he has requested an increase in the North Africa unit.
Company! Halt! Line! Fight!
At Army posts and camps throughout the United States, she's taken up not only the clerical or stenographic sort of duties she might have had in civilian life, but also she's been given new kinds of jobs requiring newly acquired skills. As a dispatcher for the Air Corps, a motor pool mechanic, a radio operator efficiently handling the new and complicated GI equipment. She's freeing fighting men for the job of getting the war over with in a hurry. Now that the WAC enrollment quota has jumped from 25 to 150,000 and they're appearing all over in increasing numbers, a lot of guys have an honest curiosity. Forget the idle chatter. On the level, what is this WAC outfit? The Women's Army Auxiliary Corps was formed by an act of Congress at the request of the War Department. General George C. Marshall, Chief of Staff, said that the use of available woman power in the Army would contribute materially to the successful prosecution of the war. One of America's most distinguished women, Mrs. Oveta Culp Hobby, was appointed director of the newly formed Corps with rank corresponding to that of Colonel in the Army. Every WAC is a volunteer. She enlists because she wants to. She's going in of her own free will to help win the war quickly. She's between 21 and 45 and must be an American citizen. First off, she gets a mental alertness test, and then an interview with an officer who determines her suitability for the Corps. Then, if she passes her physical, she's sworn in and sent to one of the five basic training centers where she undergoes 4 weeks of tough basic training. Complete GI routine from typhoid and tetanus shots through military courtesy right down to KP. All of it except for the manual of arms. Both physically and mentally, the training is strict and comprehensive. Whether it's chemical warfare drill or Red Cross life-saving practice, she's got a lot to learn and do in 1 month. From here, she may get orders for duty at an Army post. Or she may continue her training at one of the six specialist schools where she will study further for a specific duty. Officer candidates are recommended by their commanding officer, then interviewed by a board. If they manage this hurdle, they spend 6 more weeks of study. The successful few are then commissioned third officers, second lieutenants to you. Each company assigned to a post is self-sufficient with its own administrative officers, its own PX, its own mess with whack cooks, and its own fatigue details. Here again, it's apparent that the WAC is determined to prove she's primarily a soldier, asking no special consideration or attention. Why not? Well, for one thing, most of the WACs have a brother or a boyfriend or a husband somewhere in the service. Like this auxiliary whose son is in ODs overseas. Sometimes he's been wounded or has given his life and can't fight any longer. This officer's husband was killed in battle, but she's receiving the Purple Heart awarded him. It's her war, too. Yes, it's their war, too. And as the Women's Army Auxiliary Corps begins its second year of even greater, more expanded activity, America has reason to salute its women soldiers, all part of the same army, all working to win the same war, and all strictly GI.
Joining the fun, the jabbing, the jabbing, hunting the hun. And look at the job that they hand out to me, KP. 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 And KP. Policing the camp, all the trouble that's mine. You get through with this, then they stand you in line. They jab you for this, then they jab you for that. If you're asking me, it's a pain in the crap. If I ran this army, boy, I'm telling you, I'd make a few changes. That's just what I do. Gonna beat Hitler, that joint.